This is a mini lecture on hindsight bias. Looking back, it all seems so clear. Hindsight bias is the inclination to see events that have already occurred as being more predictable than they were before they took place. In other words, after an event occurs, we tend to look back on that event as being something that we should have seen coming, or in fact, did see coming. And hindsight bias often occurs when you learn something new in a class. Maybe learning it was difficult, but after you learn it, you think that anyone else should be able to learn it easily. Or perhaps that everyone else already knows it. Or, as Dr. Watson said to Sherlock Holmes, anything seems commonplace once explained. Hindsight bias is captured in the exclamation, "I knew it all along." At a wedding, someone looks at the happy couple and says, "Yeah, I knew from the moment I first saw them together that they were going to get married." Unless, of course, they break up. And then the same person says, "You know, I had my doubts about them from the start." If you are unfortunate enough to have been a political leader when something has gone horribly wrong, you will likely be the victim of others' hindsight bias. After the fact, someone will say, "They should have known." That is what was said of Admiral Husband Kimmel after the Japanese surprise attack on Pearl Harbor in 1941. He should have seen it coming. All of the signs were there. How could he have missed them? And so he was relieved of his command by Admiral Chester Nimitz. After the Space Shuttle Challenger explosion in 1986, many critics suggested that NASA should have known that it was too cold to launch that day. George W. Bush was criticized for FEMA's slow response to the flooding of New Orleans after Hurricane Katrina because he should have known that that flooding would occur. And after the attacks of 9/11, it was pointed out that the FBI had warned the president that Osama bin Laden was determined to strike in the United States. He should have seen it coming. But are those criticisms entirely fair? Was it really that easy to have seen it coming? It is easy to look back, after an event occurs, with perfect 20/20 hindsight, and then find all of the clues leading up to the event. Even Admiral Nimitz, who replaced Admiral Kimmel after Pearl Harbor, said of his old friend, "It could have happened to anybody. No one else would have seen it coming either." So let's see if you, too, can be a victim of hindsight bias. I am going to teach you something unrelated to statistics, and then see if you understand the concept. And then I'm going to test you on it. Now, this is an example that I learned from Dr. Eric Mazur from Harvard when he visited our university to talk about learning. His concept is from the field of physics, and it states, molecules expand when heated. Now, this is why you would not want to lay railroad tracks in the winter, because in the summer heat, the rails will expand and buckle the rails. And this is why you see expansion joints in bridges. In the summer, the whole metal bridge expands, and it closes the joints. In the winter, the bridge shrinks slightly, and the gaps open. So when we have molecules that are cold, they are close together. But when they are heated, they expand. When they cool down, they get closer together. But you heat them back up again, they expand. Cold, hot. Cold, hot. Any questions? Do you understand this concept? Do you understand it well enough that you can apply it? Okay, let's try. Here we have a 1-inch steel plate with a circle cut in the center. We are going to heat it up. My question for you is, when we heat it, will the circle get larger? Will the circle get smaller? Or will the circle stay the same size? Take what you know about molecules and heat and answer that question. Do you have it? Do you think you know the answer? share your answer with someone near you. The correct answer is that the entire plate will expand and the circle will get larger. This might help to explain it. Simplify the problem. Strip away everything but the ring of molecules inside the circle. Imagine that there are 10 of us standing in a circle holding hands. We are all molecules. We get heated up. So what are we going to have to do to expand? What will we have to do to be further from each other? What will that do to our circle? It will get bigger. The whole metal plate will get bigger. When I do this example in class, everyone says, "I understand the concept." But I'm amazed at how many people get it wrong. Now, of course, maybe I'm a little deceived by hindsight bias myself, because the first time I was shown the example, I got it wrong. But now that it has been explained, it was obvious all along. Looking back, it all seems so clear. So what does this have to do with statistics? As you are learning statistics, we will learn lots of new material. You are very likely to hear something once or watch me do an example and think, "Well, that looks easy. I understand that." But later on, I hear students say, "It was really easy when we did it in class, but then when I got to the homework, I forgot everything." It's not that you forgot it. You did not really learn it. You overestimated how much you understood. Looking back at the example, it seems easier than it was. So in statistics class, be skeptical of your own understanding. Assume that you understand less than you do, and then ask questions for clarification. Don't assume that hearing something once or reading it once is enough for you to learn it. Spend a little time every day reviewing what you are learning, because it is normal to think that you understand and then find out that you overestimated your understanding. Hindsight bias happens to all of us. It will happen to you. And your best defense against hindsight bias is to never assume that you know something the first time, and spend plenty of time reading, listening, and reviewing what you've learned in this course.